السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1912 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we focus on the 17th of Rajab. It was on the 17th of Rajab, 1256, corresponding to 15 September 1840, the Ottoman army clashed with the French and English navy on the coast of Beirut. They managed to defeat the Egyptian military commander Ibrahim Pasha. Now let's just look at the situation. One side is the Ottoman army. On the other side, you find it is the French and the English, but they managed to defeat the Egyptian military commander. What is this telling us? That some of the Egyptians, they joined the enemy to fight the Ottoman Empire, and this is an Ottoman army. So this is the crime committed by the Arabs. Remember, there are many asbab and reasons for the fall and the decline of the Ottoman Empire after 6 centuries, 620 years plus. Nevertheless, one of this was Arab nationalism, that the enemies put in their hearts and mind that how come you all are being controlled by these people, the Turks, and they are not Arab, they are non-Arabs and so forth and so on. So therefore, this Naqdul Qawmiyya, which Sheikh bin Baz has written, Naqdul Qawmiyyat al-Arabiyya, is an excellent book to read. You must remember, in Islam, there is no such thing. La fadla li arabiyyin ala ajamiyyin, wa la li ajamiyyin ala arabiyyin illa bit taqwa. So remember, taqwa is the only criteria by Almighty Allah after Iman. Surah 49 and verse number 13, Almighty Allah speaks of this. Inna akramakum inda Allah yatqakum. Till today, the Arab countries are paying the price. There is not a single army among the Arabs that can take on Israel. Rather, they will go and do boot licking of the Israelis, as you can see nowadays. So this is because they were the cause and the reason for the fall of the Khilafat. And then they became all satellite states, all controlled by America and so forth. But they get more and more disgraced by the Americans, as one can see today. So may Almighty Allah open our eyes and ears and our iman, so that we can understand who our real enemies are and who are our real friends. Similarly, on the 17th of Rajab 1387, 21st October 1967, Egypt sinks an Israeli torpedo boat. If you study the 67 war, the 73 war and all that, you will find many a time the Muslims, the Arabs had the upper hand. But what happened was America intervened and so forth. And you must remember, then the tables turned against the Muslims and the Arabs and so forth. So this is what happens, that they are accomplices in this crime. Israel is an illegitimate state, remember that. Its mother is Britain and father is America, and Europe and all of them accomplices. They are media accomplices and so forth. They will give you slanted news and so forth. Up to this day, you must remember that. So if the Muslim and Palestinian, the Arab and Palestinian, he shot, they will say that that Palestinian tried to stab the Israeli, or he threw stones or something. Sometimes it's all lies and this type of things there. But to cover the Jews and to cover the Israelis, so we see that these type of things are happening. So here again we see that if we have that iman, see the children of Palestine, they realize the Arabs, majority of the Arab, I'm speaking of the governments, not the people, majority of the Arab governments have sold them out, the Muslims have sold them out, the governments. So the children of Palestine, they have that iman. Khaybar, Khaybar, ya Yahud, inna jaysha Muhammad sofa Yahud. The children of Palestine, they put so much fear in the hearts of these Israeli terrorists, state terrorists. So may Almighty Allah grant, protect Haramain Sharifain, protect Masjid al-Aqsa, and grant us and show us the liberation of Palestine, Masjid al-Aqsa, during our lifetime. Ameen. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.